If you're experiencing an issue with your computer, you may be able to fix it yourself. We're going to share some of the main issues people face and the simplest way to get up and running again. We've all been there, you're in the middle of something important on your computer and everything freezes. Here are some things to try to get your computer unstuck. Try this first. It's highly likely that you are running multiple programs and your computer is trying to process too much at once. The number one tip in this situation is to open up Task Manager. Press Ctrl-Alt-Delete on your keyboard and open Task Manager. You can end any or all of the programs to see if your computer comes back to life. If this doesn't work, it's worth forcing your computer to reboot. Hold down the power button for a few seconds to force your computer to turn off, and then boot it up again. Hopefully, it will restart without a problem. Forcing your computer to reboot will cause anything that is currently open to be lost, so make sure that you're using autosave in any programs that support it. Troubleshooting ideas for dealing with the blue screen of death. While the Windows blue screen of death is always a scary sight, often Windows will fix it automatically. It will run some data behind the scenes and analyze this for you, and then restart your computer. When you see the blue screen of death, jot down the error code in case it's not resolved automatically. Chances are you'll be back in business by now. However, if you notice that something still isn't right, you can investigate further. Enter your error code into your browser, and it's likely that you'll see a number of results. Follow any of the recommendations from trusted sites such as the Microsoft website or partner sites from computer manufacturers, for example. If you continue getting the blue screen of death regularly after resolving it, you may have some faulty hardware and want to seek professional advice from a technician. Troubleshooting tips for upgrading Windows. If you're trying to upgrade to the latest and greatest version of Windows, check your computer meets the following. Firstly, it has enough space. With Windows 10, you'll need 16GB free on the main system drive. Windows 11 requires at least 64GB free on your main system drive. Number 2, that your computer meets certain requirements, such as a processing speed of 1GHz or higher and a minimum of 1GB of RAM. Windows 11 requires 4GB as a minimum. Check the full specs and requirements if you're buying a new computer and want to install Windows. The majority will meet the criteria, but if Windows is essential to you, your computer must be compatible. Troubleshooting help for doing a software reboot on Windows. Windows will automatically update for you. While this is great in theory, it means the system reboots, and this may be while you're in the middle of something. Luckily, you can avoid the issue by requesting an alert before it updates. This means that Windows will have to politely ask you if it's a convenient time for you before rebooting. To change the setting, head to Settings, Windows Update, and Advanced Options. And then enable the Notify to Schedule Restart setting. We hope you found this knowledge video informative for learning about resolving issues with a frozen PC or the blue screen of death. Subscribe to make sure you don't miss out on any future knowledge videos from CCleaner.